Hi friends, in this video we talk about monostable multivibrator. So already I discussed about what is multivibrator and stable multivibrator in one video. Please refer that before watching this video. So the monostable indicates it has one stable state and one quasi stable state. We can call that is unstable state. So since it has one stable state, mono is one, so we call this is a monostable multivibrator. Okay, so what is the difference between a stable multivibrator and monostable multivibrator? In a stable multivibrator, we don't have trigger pulse, no trigger input required. In monostable multivibrator, we need trigger pulse. Trigger pulse is required. Trigger input is required. Right? And it has, what about this? No stable state. Here, one stable state. Okay. So, what is the stable state in monostable multivibrator is, the stable state is normally off state is called stable state in monostable multivibrator. So, this is normally off. This is off mode, right? We know this pulse is off condition. This is stable state. Right? This is on. On is called unstable state. Right? Normally off is stable state. Okay. So where we have seen this scenario on real time example, we can see is our calling bell. Right? So there we have seen that it is normally off, right? When we give trigger input, that is when we press, it will go to some other state and it will ring and come back to the original state. So we apply trigger to go from on to off to on, right? So this is normally our bell is off, we apply trigger, it goes to on. But to reverse back to off, we don't need to apply trigger. So the same condition, same principle is used in the, we can compare our monostable multivibrator with what you call our calling bell. So this is what happens in the monostable multivibrator. Let us see the operation of the monostable multivibrator now. So here as usual, like we had in our a stable multivibrator, here we have two transistors, cross coupled transistors, right? This transistor is coupled to this one, Q1 is coupled to Q2, similarly Q2 is coupled to Q1. So Q1 coupled to Q2 via C1 and Q2 coupled to Q1 via R3. So this we must know. Okay, next what are the things we have to know is, so this is a triggering area, triggering circuit. So I can call this triggering circuit. This we don't have in our a stable multivibrator, right? So and another thing we have to know is transistor operates as a switch, or transistor works as switch in this circuit, like we had in our a stable multivibrator. Okay, it will be either in cutoff region or saturation region. Okay, let us see the operation now. Okay, let me erase this, then only I can write here itself. Okay, so let us see what will happen when, so both the transistors are having identical characteristics. So even though they are identical, what will happen when we, when the circuit is switched on, so due to the some characteristics mismatch, so no two transistors can be exactly identical, some characteristics mismatch. Let us assume Q2 is on. So I told you on first. So it is switch on first. So when transistor is on, I told it will be in saturation mode, right? So it goes to saturation mode. It goes to saturation mode means it will become short circuit. It acts as a closed switch, right? So when it acts as a closed switch, let us assume this point is A and this point is B. So that is what is the collector voltage or VA. So VA is zero now because all the drops goes to ground. So now the potential at point A or collector voltage is zero. Clear? So since it is zero and that zero is applied to base of the transistor Q1, so transistor Q1 is off only. Right, so transistor Q1 is off. Since transistor Q1 is off, it acts as an open switch. Right, so that is, it is in cutoff region. So now here it is in saturation region, but it is off, so it is in cutoff region. So what will happen? Now the potential at point B is, all the drops occurs here. So VB is equal to VCC. Fine. So this has happened. This is what initial state. So Q2 is on, right? So VA is zero, Q1 is off, VB is VCC. Now we see, now this is VCC. This point is VCC. That is, this point is VCC. Now what is the potential here? Here also VCC. Here also VCC. So the drop is zero. The voltage drop between these two terminals is zero. So what has happened? There is no current flow through this circuit. So the, since there is no current, what is the voltage across this capacitor? Sorry, it is VC zero. The voltage across capacitor is zero. So let us assume capacitor C1. So VC1 is zero, right? Since there is no charging, the voltage is zero. Fine. Okay, so this is what happening in the first stage. Okay, now let us see what will happen. Now what we are doing is, now okay, let me erase this, then I will explain again. Now once we apply triggering input, what happens here is, when we apply triggering input, for example trigger pulse we apply, this is a differentiator circuit, this circuit is differentiator circuit, right? So when we apply trigger input, what will happen when the voltage is this NPN transistor, right? So actually it should be like this, please change it. Right, so when we apply trigger pulse, when you apply a trigger pulse, what will happen here is, so this is a differentiator circuit. So it will give either this area or this area. So it will be a narrow pulse. Either this pulse will be sent as input or this pulse. This one is differentiator circuit output. So these two will be front out. We know when you differentiate this pulse, it is passed through a differentiator circuit. Differentiator means it will indicate the rate of change. Sorry. Where you feel rate of change? Here there is no change, here only it will be change at this node. So similarly here there is no change, at this point only we will feel the change. So this will be like this. So either this part will be sent or this part will be sent. So when this part is sent, what will happen? Now transistor Q1 will become on, right? So Q1 is getting on. Since Q1 is on, so this is initial. This is okay, let me call before triggering. This is before we apply trigger. This is after trigger. So when we apply trigger, what will happen? Q1 is on. Since Q1 is on, it is acting as a closed switch. That is saturation mode. So So transistor goes to saturation. So what will happen to the voltage at point A? So VA becomes zero because all drops to ground. So it's VB, right? It is B. So VB becomes zero. Right? Okay. So what will happen now? Now this is zero. This is for this transistor Q2. So now Q2 becomes off. Now Q2 gets off. Since Q2 is off, it will become an open circuit. So open switch cutoff region. So VA becomes VCC. Right? Since VA becomes VCC. Okay. So now what will happen to the charging capacitor? Now what happens to this charging capacitor? Here you see, now the voltage at this point is zero. This point is having a potential of VCC. So drop is VCC. So this capacitor starts getting charged. So when it reaches, so this capacitor is charging now. Before triggering, it doesn't charge. Now it is getting charged. So once it is getting charged, and when the charge value VC1 becomes VCC, right? So now when VCC becomes greater than 0.7, what will happen is, let me erase this. Right, so once VCC is greater than, the voltage across capacitor is greater than 0.7, VC1 is greater than 0.7, which is a cutting voltage of a transistor, what will happen is the transistor Q2 starts, when VCC, sorry, when voltage across capacitor is greater than 0.7, what will happen? This transistor goes to on. On means it will become, so Q2 becomes on. When Q2 becomes on, this cycle repeats. Yes, and that's what we know. So this is zero, this will become off, this will become VCC, and this will become zero. Right? So now you see, when you want to make transistor Q2 to go from on to off, that is zero to VCC, right? We apply trigger. Like we apply calling bell. Right, so after that we didn't apply trigger input, it comes to zero automatically. This is what I told, this is normally off state, stable state. It will be in stable state always. Right, so once you apply trigger, it will go to VCC. This is VCC, right? So immediately, so after some time, right, what is the time? It depends on this charging. So RC value plays crucial role. So depending on R2 and C1, what will happen? This makes the transistor Q2 goes to on again. So then it will become normally off. So it is off, this is on. So it is stable, this is unstable, right? To go from on to off, we need to apply trigger input, because after trigger only it goes to on to off. But to go from off to on, we didn't apply any trigger. This is made possible because of the value of capacitor charging. So R2 and C1 only plays crucial role. Automatically it goes to off state again based on the value of capacitor and resistor. So we don't need to apply trigger input. So it has one stable state, one unstable state. This is unstable state. From stable state to unstable state, apply trigger. Unstable to stable, it will automatically come back. That's why it is called a monostable multivibrator. It has only one stable state. That's what I told here, right? So now what we have to know is, okay, what is the pulse width? Right? So the pulse width of the monostable multivibrator is given by the width of the pulse. The pulse width is given by T, that is equal to 0.69 into what you call these two resistor value. What are those resistor value? I told here it is R2 C1. So the derivation is not required for exam. So we need only answer. So R to C1, right? So in this way, we can No, it has only one stable state and one quasi-stable state.